mean, technically coldest place you can be on Earth, but -199 right now. 98.
I am at CryoPDX here in Portland, Oregon, and I'm going to be trying cryotherapy for the first time. Let's go. Hi, how are you doing? I don't know if we spoke on the phone.
Yeah,
definitely.
Nice to meet you.
Excellent, nice to meet you too.
Cryotherapy is a procedure that exposes the body to temperatures colder than negative 200 degrees for about 3 minutes. The practice is said to have originated in Japan in the late 1970s when a Japanese rheumatologist used cold temperatures to treat his patients' painful joints.
Yeah, I don't really know what to expect. Did very little research. Thought it'd be more fun that way.
After hearing about the benefits of cryotherapy from reducing joint pain to increasing the speed of muscle recovery, I wanted to see what I was missing and try it out for myself.
So they gave me a fresh pair of socks and this robe and gloves, and they told me to let me know when I'm all changed up. Feels very bizarre. Ready to get frozen.
First time session is 2.5 minutes, and then subsequent regular sessions after that are just 3 minutes. So there's not a huge difference. First time you're just kind of getting acclimated to the cold.
Yeah. How is that the temperature up there going down?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's reading in Fahrenheit, cooling down to negative 184, so that way when you step in, you're like at a therapeutic temperature the whole time.
So it goes over your head too?
No, so you're gonna step in and then I'm gonna go ahead and raise you up. There's a lid, so we wanna make sure that your head is above the nitrogen at all times.
That's awesome.
Yeah, you're like, I see this gas going on, I don't know about that.
We're gonna have a Han Solo situation.
Yeah. Probably. You're just gonna stand there, you're gonna turn and be like, I know.
What would you say is the biggest misconception of cryotherapy, if there is?
I mean, I think the biggest one is that it's similar to cold baths or ice baths. A cryotherapy session is just so far past anything that an ice bath could give you. Not to say that ice baths aren't beneficial, but you're not having a release of serotonin or norepinephrine or your metabolic rate increasing or anything like that. You go ahead and step in right now.
Keep
the rope on for a second, and then I'm going to close the door. I'm going to go ahead and lift you up so that your head is clear, and then you can go ahead and take that rope off and hand it over to me. And that way we're maximizing the skin contact, but a little bit musty. Perfect. And I'm going to go ahead and get it started here. But yeah, I mean, cryotherapy was originally developed in Japan, 1978, Dr. Yamaguchi. And it was for rheumatoid arthritis. That's what was originally developed to combat. So inflammation in the body, like that's the number one thing it's going after.
It's not as bad as you would imagine negative 190 would be.
I mean, technically coldest place you can be on Earth, but negative 199 right now, 98. It's cold, but it's not shocking.
Yeah. I'm cold, but I'm not cold at the same time.
Yeah. And we got 3 seconds left, so once it's done, I'm gonna go ahead and leave the room. Push the door open, close it behind you, get dressed, and just come out to the front.
All right. It really wasn't that cold, though, surprisingly.
Do you have, like, a burst of energy?
A little bit. It's not, like, I expected it to be kind of like adrenaline, like, back and dressed again, feeling good. I feel flexible. And I feel warm. Surprisingly. My legs feel like, I feel like a light.
Do you feel young?
Easily 25 years younger. I feel like I'm 4 again. For sure.
Is that a joke? Or no?
It is a joke.
No.
I don't think I feel any younger, but I'm also not old, so. Do I get any more pump? Do my triceps look better? Feel good, though.
I had a really great experience with cryotherapy. Although I don't have any regular muscle soreness or pain, it is undeniable what cold therapy can do to the right people. If you're an athlete operating at a high level or someone that experiences regular pain or muscle soreness, I'd highly recommend that you check your area for a cryo chamber near you. This wasn't a sponsored video, but I'd like to thank Sydney and Andy over at CryoPDX for being such gracious hosts and allowing us to film this video. I hope you all enjoyed this. Have a great rest of your week, and I'll talk to you in the next one.